This is your eyeball, right? This is a model of eyeball. Let's first see the parts of eyeball. I'm just revising in a very short brief, right? This is your sclera, cornea covering it, iris, right, and your pupil. Behind the pupil is inside is your lens, right? Sclera, cornea, iris, blue color iris, right? Cornea is transparent, covering the iris part, and this is your pupil. The cornea is transparent, covering the iris like this, and between the sclera and the cornea, this is called sclerocorneal junction. Sclerocorneal junction. Now, the whole eyeball is divided by an imaginary line, which is called equator. It's called equator. Posterior to the equator, this posterior area, right? This posterior area is divided into four regions. 1, 2, 3, 4. Specifically, this region, which is called posterior superior region, posterior superior part, which lies behind the equator. Behind the equator, this posterior superior part is very important because here the two oblique muscles, the superior oblique and the inferior oblique muscle, will receive an insertion, right? Will attach here. Understood the model of an eyeball, right? I'll try to show you my best to so you can understand the attachment. Now, how many muscles are there? Extraocular, how many extraocular muscles are there? There are six in number. The four recti and the two obliques muscle. Recti are what? How many recti? Four. Superior recti, inferior rectus, medial rectus, and the lateral rectus. And how many obliques we have? Two obliques. The superior oblique and the inferior oblique. Understood this point? Right, now let's begin further. The recti, all the recti, right, all the four recti arises from a common tendinous ring, right? Look, I have told you this common tendinous ring, which was present towards the apex, right, towards the apex near the superior orbital fissure. I hope you remember that diagram. Let me show you again. Right, this is a superior orbital fissure, optic canal, that is covered by a common tendinous ring. This is the lesser wing of the sphenoid, right, towards the roof of the orbit, right? So from the common tendinous ring, this is your common tendinous ring giving origin to all recti muscles. So four recti, right? Superior recti, inferior, medial, and the lateral. Why recti? Because they are straight, right? They are straight. So now where they insert, the insertion of the recti are forwarded in a cone of muscle. They form a cone, right? So the apex of the cone is this, and this is the base of the cone. This will form a base of the cone. Let's see how they receive an insertion. All right. First, I show you the attachment. Just see this diagram here. I have drawn this diagram here. This is the eyeball, right? And the visual axis is passing through a eyeball. So let's first make an visual axis passing through a eyeball. Just give me 1 second. This is the visual axis, right? Anteroposteriorly, passing through a center of the eyeball. Understood? this pink line, this pink is visual axis of an eyeball, right? So same I have tried to draw here. This is the visual axis of the eyeball. You will realize that the common tenderness ring lies towards the medial side, lies towards the medial side of a visual axis, right? Not just behind it. It lies little medially, more medially, right? And all the muscles are originating from there and inserting in front of the equator, in front of the equator of the eyeball, right? So if you notice the axis of the superior oblique, in fact, the inferior oblique muscle also lies just below this, right? The inferior rectus, sorry, I'm really sorry, the superior rectus, just below the superior rectus lies the inferior rectus in the same axis. And if you'll try to trace the axis, and when you will compare it with the visual axis, there's a distance of 25 degrees, right? So the superior rectus axis lies laterally to the visual axis, the distance of 25 degrees. Understood? So they are not lying in a same axis of an eyeball. Understood this point? Now let's see. Now let's start attaching the muscles, right? So I'll begin first with the, I'm turning it. This is my equator, right? And I'll try to attach the muscles over this. This is the common tendinous ring, and this is superior rectus here. This is superior rectus. First, I'll attach the superior rectus. I'll take the superior rectus. This is my common tendinous ring lying more medially, right? And I will attach the superior rectus beyond the equator, 6 to 8 mm behind the sclerocorneal junction. Behind the 8 mm to sclerocorneal junction. I hope you remember the sclerocorneal junction. This is the visual axis and this is the axis of my superior rectus. So the angle will form in front is between the both the axes, the angle will be of 25 degrees, right? Now I'm placing the inferior rectus in the same axis as of the inferior rectus muscle, right? They are in the same plane, right? Now I'll attach. Now I will attach the lateral rectus. The lateral rectus lies 7 mm behind the sclerocorneal junction. The lateral rectus lies 7 mm behind the lateral rectus. And in the end is the medial rectus, which lies nearest to the sclerocorneal junction. That is, right, 5 mm beyond the sclerocorneal junction. Just 5 mm. So, this is your visual axis. And this is your common tendinous ring, right? This is the axis of your superior rectus muscle, which will pass like this, right? And this is your visual axis. I hope you understood this point, right? I'm rotating my model here, showing the attachment of superior rectus, medial rectus, and the lateral rectus, and down below the inferior rectus muscle. Understood? Now, I am going to attach the oblique muscles. This is the visual axis. This is superior oblique. And this is superior oblique. It has a pulley. I have tried to show a pulley here, right? So, the origin is beyond the lesser wing. So it originates from the just beyond and above and medial to the common tendinous ring, right? It will go more medial. It will go more medial to the medial rectus, right? And from the pulley, it will turn back it will turn back. It will turn back and will receive an attachment over the posterior superior quadrant of the eyeball. This is the posterior superior quadrant of the eyeball. Just overlapping the superior rectus muscle. In this way, the superior oblique will come. This will go down below the superior rectus. Down below the superior rectus and will receive an insertion over the posterior superior quadrant of the eyeball beyond means behind the equator. Look, all the recti are going in front of the equator. This is the equator line. This is the equator line. And the oblique muscle receives an insertion over the eyeball behind the equator in the posterior superior quadrant. And this is your pulley here. See the direction of the superior oblique, right? In this way, this was coming like this from behind, right? And suddenly when the pulley, it reached to the pulley, it changed its direction. It went back, right? Behind, backwards and downwards and received the insertion over the posterior superior quadrant of the eyeball behind the equator. Understood this point? Now let's see the origin of your inferior oblique muscle, right? The inferior oblique muscle arises from where? It arises from the inferior surface. It arises from the inferior surface of the, or you can say floor of the orbit. Floor of the orbit ke medial side se originate leti hai. Isko main niche lagaungi. Means it lies below the inferior rectus. It lies below the inferior rectus. It lies below the inferior rectus and comes upwards, backwards, and receives its insertion over this area in the posterior superior quadrant area behind the equator, just near the insertion of a superior oblique. So this is the direction of an inferior oblique muscle. I hope you understood the attachments of the extra auricular muscles. Understood? I have made a small diagram for better understanding. This is your superior rectus, inferior rectus, right? This is the plane of superior rectus and inferior rectus, which is going like this and at an angle of 25 degree with the visual axis. Now see the attachment of superior oblique from behind the common tendinous ring, means from the lesser wing, medial side, it is coming, right? Going like this, and when the pulley comes, it changes its direction, going backwards, forwards and downwards, right? It going backwards and downwards and receiving its insertion over the posterior superior quadrant lying just behind the equator, and the inferior oblique, which is in the same axis, right, passing just below the superior oblique, and it comes over this quadrant area and receives the insertion just near to the superior oblique. Now if you'll notice the direction axis of superior oblique or inferior oblique muscle, right, you will see just pass an imaginary line through this. With the visual axis, there is a distance of, there is an angulation of 51 degrees, right? So in this also there is an axis change in the muscle's action will be different. And the visual axis is different, the axis of muscles are different. Even if you say the recti, there's a 25 degree, and if you say the axis of superior oblique, there's a distance of 51 degrees, right? Now if you ask me, ma'am, what is the axis of the medial rectus and the lateral rectus, that is your transverse axis, means over the equator. The axis is passing through the equator. Understood? So the axis of the medial rectus and the lateral rectus is transverse, right? And the axis of superior rectus and the inferior rectus is slightly oblique, right? In the oblique plane, right? Which is making an angle of 25 degrees, right? And the oblique muscle is, axis is directed backwards and laterally, right? And making an axis of 51 degrees, of making an angle of 51 degrees. Now, axis of movement. Axis of movement means movements. First of all, we just need to check ki eyeball kya kya movements perform kar sakti hai. The first is elevation and depression of the eyeball, abduction and reduction of the eyeball. Let's see over the model here. This is your eyeball, right? First is elevation and depression, right? Elevation and depression. Then second is abduction towards the medial, and abduction is lateral side, and adduction. Abduction and adduction. Elevation and depression. Understood? Now, torsions of eyeball. Torsion means this movement occurs at the AP axis. Elevation and depression. The axis is transverse. The axis is transverse. Right? Abduction and adduction occurs in vertical axis. Means the axis is passing through and through the eyeball. Vertical axis. Right? And the torsion of the eyeball means internal torsion when it is moving towards the medial side eyeball. And external torsion when the eyeball is moving outside. So this is the internal torsion, this is the external torsion. The internal and the internal and the external torsion axis is anteroposterior, means the same visual axis. I'm repeating again, elevation and depression of the eyeball in the transverse axis, this way. Understood? The abduction and adduction, the vertical axis, means the axis is passing through the center of the eyeball, right? And the intorsion and extorsion, where the eyeball is moving inwards and the eyeballs outwards, right? The axis passes anteroposteriorly, AP axis, means coinciding with the visual axis. Action of the muscles. First, let's see the individual actions of the muscle. Superior rectus. This is your superior rectus. If there is a contraction of the superior rectus, right? Just focus over this area, right? When I will pull the superior rectus, there is initially an elevation, right? On further elevation, remember the axis of this muscle also, okay? So it is not in the same plane as the visual axis, right? So when this will contract, the superior rectus contracts, there is an elevation. There is an elevation. I'm pulling the muscle here, from here. Elevation. Right? With the elevation, on further elevation, there is an intorsion. With elevation, there is an intorsion. The eyeball moves. Just focus over this, this mark area. Right? First, there is an elevation. Then on further contraction, there is an intorsion. Means inward moving. Inward moving of an eyeball with more further contraction of this muscle, superior rectus, there is a slight adduction, very slight adduction, right? So what it is causing, the superior rectus contraction causes the elevation, intorsion, and very slight adduction, right? Majorly, the adduction is done by the medial rectus. I'm pulling the medial rectus. So it is moving towards the nose. The eyeball is moving towards the nose. The lateral rectus, when I pull the lateral rectus, will produce the abduction. Abduction. Understood? Now, while pulling the inferior rectus, this is your inferior rectus, right? When I will pull the inferior rectus, the eyeball depression. The inferior rectus produces depression. With depression, according to the axis of the inferior rectus, which is same as of the superior rectus, when the muscle contracts more, then from the depression, there is an extorsion, right? The eyeball move outside, right? There's a movement of the eyeball outside, extorsion. With more pulling, there is an adduction. right? So when there is an inferior rectus muscle contraction, this is the inferior rectus. When the inferior rectus contracts, there is a depression. There is a depression. Further contraction causes the extension, and finally it causes the adduction. Understood how they are working? Now let's see the action of superior oblique. I have already discussed the medial rectus and the lateral rectus part. This is causing the adduction and this is causing the abduction. Now let's see the superior oblique muscle. This is a superior oblique muscle coming beyond the from the lesser wing of the sphenoid, right? This is the pulley and this is the muscle going to the posterior superior quadrant of the equator. Now I'm going to pull the muscle and you will realize the action, right? Superior oblique. First, pulling. See this point. This is coming down. Depression. Right? Depression. With the depression, further contraction will cause the intorsion of the eyeball. The intorsion of the eyeball. Right? And when this is happening, when the depression and the intorsion is happening, the eyeball slightly moves towards the outside, means abduction. So there is a depression, intorsion, and the eyeball moves towards outside. That is abduction. Now let's see the inferior oblique. This is your inferior oblique. The inferior oblique contracts. This causes elevation. This is causing what? Elevation. The eyeball is elevating. Slight elevation is there. Elevation. Right? When there is further contraction of the muscle, this is rotating the eyeball outside. Extorsion. Extorsion. Right? On further contraction, there is an abduction. There is an abduction. Understood? Understood? Now I'm repeat again. When there is a contraction of superior oblique, depression. With intorsion, and when there is a depression and intorsion, the eyeball moves outside, abduction. When there is a pulling of inferior oblique, there is an elevation. There is an elevation, right? With extorsion going that side, right? And further contraction causes abduction. Further contraction causes abduction. Understood? Now you need to understand this, that no movement means elevation, depression, abduction, reduction. Ye single muscle ki movements nahi hai. Do muscles, two or three muscles are contributing. When if you say there is an adduction, right? If not only the medial rectus is acting over adduction, the superior rectus and the inferior rectus, medial rectus, superior rectus and inferior rectus causing the adduction. For abduction, the lateral rectus, superior oblique and inferior oblique muscles are acting to produce abduction. For elevation, right? The superior rectus is acting and the inferior oblique is acting. For depression, the inferior rectus and the superior oblique is acting. Right? Intorsion and extorsion. In intorsion, superior rectus and superior oblique are acting. And for extorsion, means moving outside, extorsion is your inferior rectus, is your inferior oblique muscle, right? I hope you understood by this diagram. Thank you very much.